So because dictionary is not available for you all, I think so I'll have two frame questions for you all for your assertion and reasoning and your facts and opinion, okay? Now, all of you, please take out your notebooks. Again, I'm telling you, I am going to write a notice. Do you have notice writing? Yes. Now, please write down the question. Write down the question. Ma'am, do we write even? How do we write? You're supposed to write. We just have to do the ticking part. Yeah, that is it. Life is so good. Draft a notice. Draft a notice for your school notice board informing, please, at home also, start writing. Draft a notice for your school notice board informing the students of class 11th about your missing project file. Your missing project file. Any subject you can write down, right? English. We love losing our English books. We don't take care of them as it is in the first place, isn't it? Are we benign here now? Okay, so you've lost it beforehand. That is going to be your excuse, right? That is going to be your excuse. Yes, boys. So you lost about your missing English project file. Okay, we are happy, right? Give information regarding the place where you lost. Any reward for the finder? Any reward? No reward? Okay. We're miserly people, isn't it? We don't want the file only. Look at him. Right? The person can keep it. We can make it again. And other relevant details. You are Kunal, class 11th of ABC school. Yes, I would like to see your notebooks also when you write the notice. Now, come on, let's see here. What is the heading going to be? What are the things that we need to remember? Okay, what after the notice, we put the title or the heading? Yes, what would the heading be? I know that all that thing you're supposed to write. Write it down, come on. Write down, come on, put in the particulars. Write down. What about the heading? It will be missing, missing, missing. Lost, lost, lost. Right? Will it be only lost? Or you need to add more information? Only lost? Lost is enough? Yes, Harleen. What more can you add to the heading? Lost is enough? Yes, Rajit? Lost is a good enough heading? Lost what? Then? Okay. Harleen, get up. Come up here on the first bench. Move. Japish, get up. Come here. Gurkirat, get up. Garv, come here. Move. There's a bench over there. You can sit over there. Project file. lost. Okay. So, yes. So, project file lost. Yes. Right. And what about the target group? What is the target group of this notice? Yes. So, class 11th. Any particular sections, or it is for all the sections? Right. For all sections, isn't it? This is to inform. Right. What about it? Any relevant information? What can you give about? How can you describe your project file? If you have to describe your project file. Okay, you can give about the color. Yes, like she said, it was covered with the brown paper. Right? Someone is saying it's a green colored file. Right? And of course, with the heading and all written on it in. Yes. Okay, printed in black and white, whatever. Here you can give a description. Okay, where was it lost? Where was it last seen? But it is specifically for mail to kisi ko bhi sakti, absolutely true. Here it is. What is the target group? What is the target group when we write a notice? It is when I start here. This is when your opening sentence and target group are different. Right? So here your opening sentence, how would you start the notice? Come on, let's write this then. Let's write this. Let us write this, yes. This is to inform all the students, right? So maybe it is lost in the senior wing and the juniors don't come over there. You can rule out one possibility, yes? And of course, it could be that when the time it was lost, so maybe after that or before that, the junior classes, they leave, right? So we can put out the checklist also. We can put out those factors, yes? Kashish, you want to say something? No? Right. Okay, come and write your notice your way. Let us write it your way. What project file loss? This is to inform the students of the school, of all classes. Okay, which classes? 1 to 12? Are they coming? Right. Okay, so you can say 6 to 12. And of course here that project file of which class? Project file of class 11th. Lost in the school compound, right? And of course, you can give descriptions. Once again, you know, when we have lost something, you are not going to give full information, right? Of course, because somebody might, you know, pick up anything and claim it that, okay, this is the project file. So there might be something that the person is aware about, right? Maybe what about the content part or things over there, maybe the pictures which are there inside, something there. Here. Of course, color and the title and heading is quite good evidence enough or quite good information enough. Okay. So write that. Of course, it is mentioned that the project of a student of class 11th is lost during the, you can say, or in the school ground. Okay. Or in the school campus. Give the details. Of course, as you said, a green color file, right, with heading and title written on it, okay? Right, or someone has said covered with brown paper. Then what else? What else are you supposed to ask? Where to return it? Whom to return it? Yes, so where can they return it if they found it? In the class, plus 1C. Do we trust the students of plus 1C? They'll keep it safe and sound? Return it to the owner? No, Deepak is saying no. Right, so it is better. Let us give it at a like proper place here. Or yes, we can give to the class in charge. Yes, so we can make those options. So either you can hand it over to the class in charge of 11th C, or it could be at the reception or any other place which you feel is safe enough, or maybe in the library. Okay, So we are miserly people. We're not going to offer a treat to the person who finds it. Can we? A little incentive is there or not? So you can bring a chocolate from home. Can't you? Right? Kya pata dost ne chori ki ho? So achha na, maybe you've given that person some kind of incentive. He's come back with it. Yes? So maybe he's taken it so that he can complete his work and then he's going to keep it very nicely back in the same place. Yeah, I found it and two birds with one stone, isn't it? Okay, so we'll have a treat at what corner is there? Some juice corner or something that you people frequent, isn't it? Right? So yes, or you can say yes, a treat is assured to the person who finds it. Okay? So who's going to put up this notice? Who's going to put up this notice? The student who has lost it? Yes. Okay. Yeah? So I've given you all the details here that the person who is going to put up the notice. Now, supposing if you lose something in a public place, you lost your pet dog. You met your friends and you're so happy to see them after so many days that when you reached home, you forgot, oh, I had taken my dog for a walk. Where's the dog? And you go back and it's not there in the park. Poor thing, right? So if you have to write a notice about that, right? So that would be more of an advertisement than a notice. So that we will be doing that later on. Okay. Yes, here. Now let us come here. What I am telling you, you would be given inputs. You would be given hints, right? Or maybe the options would be given there that how would I, it could be numbered 1, 2, 3, 4. What will come over here? Where, your question one, right? How do I frame the heading? What is the correct heading that can be given? Question two could be, yes, about the target group or about the description of the lost object, right? Then I have maybe a number four over here. So who is the designated person who can write this notice, right? So you will be given all these multiple options and you will have to fill in the suitable blanks, okay? Now let us see if we have to place an order. You all have all kinds of letters? Yes or no? Yes, you have inquiry also. You have complaint also. Business letters are there, right? Yes? Yeah? Inquiry? Yes or no? Yes. So you want to write a letter, say placing an order. Okay, books for school. Simplest, easiest of all, I am just picking up. Yes, now let us just see the format. Do you remember the format? I discussed the format with you all. Yes or no? What are the things that you need to remember? Let us talk about the subject. What would the subject be? What is the correct way of writing the subject for placing an order? Yes, to place an order for library, or you can say for books for the library, or to place an order for reference and textbooks, depending on what you want to order for. Okay, then here after your subject and your salutation, I talk about the content. Where in the content am I going to ask or going to mention about payment? The mode of payment, right? Where am I going to ask for the date of? And where am I going to place the order? Where do they all come? Do they come in the introduction? Do they come in the content part, or is it yes? Does a placing an order have any kind of conclusion? Does it have a conclusion? What is a conclusion? So of course, so what do I write in the conclusion here? Discount and everything is already decided when you have done your letter of inquiry, isn't it? That time you have already asked for the discount, isn't it? Yes. What? So conclusion, yes. So a reminder for the date and of course the urgency or the importance of supplying on the stipulated time. What this all comes in the content? Yes. What comes first? What comes first? First comes placing order. First I play introduction and all, I assume you know that. Okay. Introduction is your reference. Yes. Right, and of course that as per our correspondence, right? So I am placing an order for the books for the library, isn't it? Right, so what will come first here? What would be I writing first in the content? The date of supply? I place the order? First is, what all have I written? Introduction, come on, see, look here, and we think we know writing letters is so easy, and I've given you the content also. You have to just place it in order. That's it. Or you can say, ma'am, it doesn't matter, as long as we get the content, it doesn't matter where we write it. For you it is, yes. Pehle hum kahein, we say you place the order first. Okay, fine. So fine, we place the order, then I talk about the mode of payment. So date of supply I will mention here also. I will mention here also, or I can mention it any way. Yes. Here I will be more specific, right? So when I talk about the date over here, I'll be very, very specific that this is by such and such date, I want the books. Here it is, I'll just give a gentle reminder that hope you will send the books on time or within the stipulated time period. What about the mode of payment here? Do I ask for discount here? Placing an order, do I ask for a discount? Do I give the person a reminder of the discount they're going to offer? Of course I will. I will give in the mode of payment. I will talk that, yes, I will tell, this is the amount that I am going to pay you after this much percent discount you had offered to us, right? Or you can say, which we have all regularly been availing for the, you can say, a discount off on the students' textbooks and for the reference books. Okay, what about the mode of payment? Will I make the complete payment? Should I make the complete payment? Yes, can I make the complete payment? So once again, yes, it is there. I can make the complete payment if I have great trust in them that they are regular suppliers of the books, right? Secondly, I can say, yes, it as per our discussion or as per our correspondence, this much I'm paying in advance and rest would be paid on receipt of the goods. Okay, right? Which receipt will I write down here? On receiving the goods, is it? Or will I say on receipt of the goods? Which is the correct one? Why take chances, ma'am? We will not write, we'll find a synonym. Is it? Yes? So of course, yeah. But if the option is there, we talk about multiple choices. We don't have another option. We have four options, but we have to pick the best one. So the moral of the story today is start reading. Okay? So please go through your writing skills, go through your grammar, go through your poems and your chapters. We have a long way to go. Today what I'm going to do is I have a passage, you know, practice passage of maybe class 12. I'll share that with you all. Practice it, write the answers, we'll discuss it tomorrow. You can do this much or not? How much honesty do I expect?